This is the Blog Oklahoma Bonus for March 31st, 2018. The other day, I was researching information on open source cloud storage servers. Fun topic. You know, like Own Cloud or Next Cloud. Well, during this search, I came across an article about an open-source note-taking app that will let you sync to Nextcloud. That intrigued me. I've been meaning to get something to help organize my notes, and I've been without a dedicated note-taking app for more than a few years now. I was a big Evernote user for a long time, and then one day they just changed their pricing model and scaled back their free tier. It just wasn't economical at the time for me to continue to use Evernote. So I exported everything out I needed and never looked back. Since then, I've been leaving sticky notes, scratch pads, text files, online documents, and note folders all over the place. It's definitely time for me to look for a new dedicated notes app. So that brings us back to this open source note-taking app I mentioned earlier. It's called Joplin. That's spelled J-O-P-L-I-N, you know, like in Missouri or Janice. Joplin is a free open-source note-taking and to-do application. It'll run on Windows, macOS, Linux, Android, and iOS. You can organize your notes into notebooks, it supports tagging, and the notes are searchable. A big plus for me, the notes are formatted using Markdown. Joplin Notes can be synchronized with various cloud services, including OneDrive, Nextcloud, Dropbox, and other web dev supported services. I've been using Joplin for a few weeks now, and I'm really liking it. I connected it to my OneDrive, which I wasn't using very much, so I got plenty of space, and it's been working rather smoothly. I can get to my notes from my desktop or from my iPhone. I just got to remember to give it a moment to sync when I open up the iPhone app. There are a few things I'd like to see in this app. At the time I'm recording this, for the desktop version, you can't sort the notebook list. You can't resize the different panels. I would really like to adjust the size of the edit panel or be able to hide the side menus. There's no spell check, and you'll have to go into settings to adjust the font and the scaling on everything. However, development is continuing on Joplin. Since I installed it, it's already updated twice, and one of those updates added the Dropbox sync support. So it's an active project. There are plenty of other note-taking applications and services you might consider, all with their pros, cons, and costs, such as Evernote, Microsoft OneNote, Google Keep, Dropbox Paper, SimpleNote, and Bear. I'll have links to each of those in the show notes if you want to look them over. Overall, I'm liking Joplin. I'm going to continue to use it for a while more. In fact, I use it to compile some of the notes for this very episode. Even with the nitpicks, it works. It's being worked on and improved right now, and it's nice to have a free and open source alternative. If you would like to try Joplin, you'll find it at joplin.kozik.net. That is at joplin.kozik.net. I don't expect you to remember that, so you'll find a link to it and more information in the show notes at blogoklahoma.net in the bonus section. Are you someone who blogs in or about Oklahoma? Then you already qualify for WebRing membership. Join Blog Oklahoma today. Want to know more about Blog Oklahoma? Then just explore the WebRing and discover some of the best blogs and podcasts in the nation. Just visit blogoklahoma.com for more information. I'm happy to announce, as of March 31st, 2018, Blog Oklahoma has 721 registered Oklahoma bloggers. Your feedback is important, so please feel free to contact me with your comments or questions. You can get hold of me in a multitude of ways. Just visit blogoklahoma.net/contact for more information. Check the show notes for all the links and bonus material from today's bonus episode. This has been Kevin Latham for Blog Oklahoma. Until next time.